incredible as our players have it all to play for here as they're getting set up. And we can start off looking at Federico here, and a very accomplished player coming into this World Championships. 2023, top 64 at the EUIC event, and was top 16 at the Liverpool Regionals earlier this year. Senior division international finalist twice as well, and a 3-times regional champion as well in the seniors division. So he is very experienced at that senior level and also at the masters level. But obviously this one is gonna be a new one that he can put on his reference chart as that top 8 at the World Championships, and maybe even top 4 or finalist or champion.
Exactly. It's never easy to level up into the Masters division, and particularly when you're against such a formidable opponent as Abdullah here. As you can see, lots of great finishes in 2023 alone, particularly that Vancouver Regional Champion title. I know Abdullah really, really wants to be able to get to the World Championship final and take that trophy. And with this really interesting team, love to see the synergy between Urshifu and Xianpao, but Pelipper's the really interesting one for me. I love to see that here on the team. Great supportive measures with the capability of something like Wide Guard as well. Something that I think has dropped off the radar for Pelipper's a little bit more. Haven't seen that move in use that much.
No, not at all. But I think when you look at the types of moves that are quite common in this new Regulation D format, you've got the signature moves of the Genies. Two of those are spread attacks, you know? So that will give you a little bit of support against those if you can see them coming out. Dazzling Gleam's quite a common spread attack. You've got Earthquake as well from the Landorus. You've got Dazzling Gleam from the Fluttermane. So there's an array of different spread attacks that can come out and affect your side of the field. So really nice option. Let's see if it comes into play in this one.
Here we go. Masters top 8 at the Pokemon World Championships. There's an Iron Hands apiece on the field. Federico pairing up with the Cresselia. And then on the opposing side for Abdullah, it is that Xianpao.
Yeah, the Xianpao and the Iron Hands can put a bit more pressure onto the side of Federico's side, obviously coming out with that Cresselia and looking probably to try and set up that Trick Room, because it will give him a bit of a speed advantage going into this match with the more speedier things on Abdullah's side of the field.
Here we go, Cresselia just wanting to avoid taking any unnecessary damage, and Urshifu being able to switch in to apply much more of an offensive pressure going forward. Iron Hands on Abdullah's side, however, wants to leave the field as well, bringing in the Golden Go. Going to be able to apply some pressure going forward with something powerful like a Make It Rain, or trying to capitalize to get a cheeky Nasty Plot up a little bit later on. Crunch coming out from the Xianpao, very critical to break the Focus Sash on that opposing Urshifu here.
Yeah, and as the Drain Punch comes out from that Iron Hands into the Goldingo, and not going to be affected because of that Ghost type. It's a really nice switch there from Abdullah, and he's put himself in a position where he can start to put some pressure on. With that Goldingo, has to be very careful though, around that Urshifu, because it is a single strike variant, and it has got access to not only the Wicked Blow, but that Sucker Punch. And with the Xianpao on the opposite side of the field, that Swords of Ruin ability, it will be increasing the damage from that single strike Urshifu, as well as that Iron Hands.
Yes, the fact that it is the single strike does mean it's applying a lot of pressure with those dark type moves. It's going to be another switch straight out of the blocks. Iron Hands rejoining the field, maybe thinking, hey, I want to try and get something like a fake out down into that next turn. But Xianpao, very speedy out the blocks, going for this Ice Spinner, does a significant chunk to the opposing Iron Hands, but it still leaves itself very vulnerable to this Wicked Blow that's going to connect down and break the Focus Sash on that opposing Xianpao.
Yeah, and then followed up with the Wild Charge, and it will be enough to pick up the knockout. And Federico taking an early lead here, getting rid of that Xianpao after going down to the double up.
Yes, losing that Treasure of Ruin Pokemon very early on for Abdullah, but it does give him the opportunity to bring a Pokemon in from the back now, maybe to apply a little bit of pressure, something. I would say the Golden Go is a little bit risky, however, because obviously it's going to fall victim to something like a Sucker Punch from that Urshifu that's very, very tempting.
Yeah, and the other thing is, as well, you're not going to get super effective damage onto the field with the Iron Hands if you are going to click into that Make It Rain, but we are seeing Yimungus come out onto the field now, going to be a bit more disruptive, a bit more supportive towards that Iron Hands that Abdullah's got. Has got the Fake Out, like we've mentioned, so he can go for that on to either the Iron Hands or the Urshifu here, and potentially put one of these Pokemon to sleep as well with a Spore timed well and going into the right slot.
Yeah, that's the thing. There's not too much that either Iron Hands or Urshifu can really do to this Amoongus. So if you time the Spore correctly, you're going to be able to put a Pokemon to sleep and try and gain a little bit more momentum. Going to be some adjustments, however. Cresselia is entering the fray here, and the Amoongus still does take a huge chunk of damage from that Wicked Blow. Iron Hands going for the Drain Punch will be able to get revenge and retribution for the Amoongus here by picking up a KO onto that opposing Urshifu here.
Yeah, not wanting to go for that Fake Out, just going for the damage to get rid of that Urshifu. Really nice switch there with the Cresselia holding that safety goggles item, knowing that the Spore was maybe coming out into that slot and catching it perfectly. Now the Ursaluna gonna hit the field for Federico, and here is the Pokemon. It wants to protect this turn. It has to because of the threat from the big fighting type attacks coming out from that Iron Hands as well as that Spore from the Amoongus. While the Cresselia is in a pretty good position now to set that Trick Room up, set this Ursaluna up to start throwing out some big attacks that next turn.
This is something I've been looking forward to seeing all weekend. The Ursaluna, one of the top picks coming into this tournament to be able to start sweeping under a Trick Room environment. That is something Cresselia does have access to. And like you said, Lee, Ursaluna wants to be able to go for that Protect so that it's going to be able to burn itself and get its Guts ability activated.
Now we are going to see the Goldingo join the fray here and put itself in a position where the Iron Hands is in the back, so it can come in again and utilize that Fake Out maybe to help stall out the Trick Room if that's what we see here. Do you see the Spore from the Amoongus into that Ursaluna, but it is going to protect itself this turn, just ensuring that that Flame Orb activates at the end of this turn, gets that Guts boost as well on top of that, and the immunity to any further status conditions coming out from that Amoongus, and it's set up ready to go now. The Goldingo not in a great spot here either, because if an Earthquake comes out or a ground type attack comes out from the Ursaluna, it can do some devastating damage. But look at the Terra type on that Goldingo. It is a flying Terra type, so if it goes for that, it can give itself an immunity for one turn at least from a big threatening ground type attack from the Ursaluna, and maybe be enough to get some damage off in return as well.
That's honestly a really nice trick for Abdullah to have up his sleeve at this point, because the Goldingo is going to be severely threatened. We take a look at Ursaluna as well. If you are the flying type Goldingo, you can't be hit with Earthquake, and the issue is, I was about to say, you can't be hit with Facade, but you'll have lost your ghost typing, so you're in a bit of a catch-22 about which option you want to go for here, which move do you think the Ursaluna is going to go for. There's not really a lot that Abdullah could have done to have stopped that Trick Room from going up, so now you've got to try and ride it out, find a way to burn through these turns and not get knocked out by this very powerful Ursaluna. It's also going for its Ghost Terror here.
Yeah, which is really not great if the Iron Hands comes back into the field, because now we'll have that immunity to the ghost, the fighting type attacks. But the one thing that it has given itself is that it has now got a weakness to ghost type attacks, which Goldingo is, and it does have access to. We are going to see a Leaf Storm here from the Amoongus fired into that slot, but it is a Cresselia after the ally switch comes, and both the Ursaluna and the Cresselia switch places, and an Earthquake following up from the Ursaluna now will hit into the Amoongus, but the Protect on the Goldingo, just keeping it safe for this last turn.
Oh, look how much damage that does. Nearly gets the KO onto the Amoongus. It's not often we see Amoongus switch to the offensive. The Leaf Storm really, really nice to be able to hit those Water-type Pokemon or Ground-type Pokemon, but Ursaluna not only being switched out of its place by the Ally Switch, but also that Ghost Terror going to be helping it out as well.
Yeah, and you look at Federico's side of the field, the Ursaluna and the Cresselia are in pretty healthy position. The Amoongus now will go down to anything that hits it. So not in the best positions, and you don't really want to switch it out at this point to bring in your Iron Hands to just take potentially another Earthquake, and you're only going to get maybe one turn where you're going to be able to utilize this flying Terra type on the Goldingo. So you've got to time it right, and then I think let the Amoongus go down to allow the Iron Hand to come onto the field so you can utilize that Fake Out the next turn. Although it will only work onto that Cresselia because of the ghost typing now attached to that Ursaluna after terrestrializing.
That's the thing, the Ursaluna is really hard to stop at this point. It's just in a great position to keep going for Earthquake. You've got the levitating partner Pokemon that's not going to worry about it at all, but it looks like the Goldingo is going to chance itself here, saying, I'm going to go into my flying type, avoid an Earthquake, that it's whether or not Federico has identified this, is maybe going to go for the Facade and try and pick up a KO against it. At the same time, Earthquake, really, really nice and safe, but we're actually going to see a safer play. It's a Protect.
Yeah, just a Protect here. Maybe just waiting just to see, no, the same thing that Abdullah did that last turn with the Goldingo, just wanting to see if the Ursaluna committed to that terrestrialization, what it locked into. But not attacking this turn, going for a nasty plot, taking advantage of this free turn here, and really putting itself in a great position going into this next turn, especially with that Fake Out now from the Iron Hands. Although, like we say, cannot Fake Out the Ursaluna, which is the Pokemon you kind of want to be faking out to prevent it from attacking this turn, especially after that Protect. But the Cresselia is a bit of a sitting duck this next turn if it wants to go for that.
I think it heard you, Lee. It's leaving the field saying, I'm not a duck. I'm going to bring in Iron Hands. If you've got one, I can get one too. I think the issue is, however, like, there are still two turns of Trick Room. Here comes the Facade into the Golden Go. It's going to get a solid KO against it. I was wondering if the Golden Go was going to maybe try and get a Protect on here, maybe try and get the double, because like you said, Lee, you cannot fake out into that Ursaluna. You can Wild Charge into it, though. It has lost its ground typing, but look at the minimal damage that it is dealing. All eyes really are on the Ursaluna at the powerhouse Pokemon at the moment.
Yeah, it's really powering through Abdullah's team, and I think you were right. I think what you needed to do, protect Goldingo then, try and get the Amoongus back onto the field, at least with that Rage Powder, and just to try and get the redirection to at least allow the Goldingo to get one attack off, especially after that nasty plot. It just went down without getting any return here for Abdullah, and not working out great for him, but Federico having complete control of this game, really looking good to close this one out now.
I guess Abdullah may be thinking, hey, it's going to be the Earthquake. I'm free to maybe try and get some damage off here. The Protect is too predictable. We are going to see a flinch come out, however, as Ursaluna just clicks that Earthquake button once again. Double knockout here. There's no stopping this bear.
Yeah, and taking everything down on the field, including its own Iron Hands to take game one in brilliant fashion, you know. Really commanding game there from Federico from start to finish. Nothing really able to take and deal with that Ursaluna, especially after Abdullah taking an early loss in this game. But the Ghost Terror-typing, not something we see too often on the Ursaluna, but a really good choice in this match.
Do you know what? I said I was looking forward to seeing Ursaluna all weekend, and it certainly did not disappoint in that game one. But this is a best of three set, so Abdullah needs to think how he's going to come into this game two and find a way to pivot around this Ursaluna. You're right, the Ghost-typing is incredibly difficult to navigate. But taking a little look at Abdullah's side, you have got Pokemon like the Urshifu that's still going to be able to hit hard with something like Surging Strikes, particularly if you're able to get those off before the Ursaluna's going into that Ghost Terror. Even if the Ursaluna wants to go for a Protect, Unseen Fist is just going to be able to bypass that and deal a significant chunk of damage. Or possibly there's a Pokemon on Federico's side you can force to go for its Terrestrialization before you're able to use it on the Ursaluna.
Yeah, and I think you're identifying some options, really good ones as well. Abdullah does have that Urshifu, and it does have the Grass Terror typing with it, and it does have access to Terror Blast. Especially with that Unseen Fist ability, like you've mentioned, it could really do some damage to Ursaluna before it is able to actively kind of get that Flame Orb activated, the Cresselia get the Trick Room up. The Trick Room getting set up is pretty, it's not ideal for Abdullah as well. He doesn't really have too many ways to kind of stop the Trick Room going up. Got Fake Out, of course, you can take advantage of with your Iron Hands, but I think that the problem in game one was he let that Chen Pao go down way too easy without getting really too much return from it, going for the Ice Spinner into the Iron Hands and then just letting it go down to the double up really felt a little bit underwhelming for Abdullah, and it just was a bit of a struggle from that point on because he didn't have too many options after that with the Goldingo. The Among Us and the Iron Hands just felt a little bit underwhelming. To get himself into a good position, he got the nasty plot off, but he wasn't really able to capitalize on that, and Federico just closed them down at every angle once the Trick Room went up and once that Ursaluna got its Ghost typing through the Terrestrialization.
You're right, Trick Room is the key to success here for Federico, and that gives Abdullah a lot of problems. When you take a look at Abdullah's team as well, there's only three Pokemon on there that can actually go for Protect. Even the Amoongus doesn't have a protecting move here, which leaves it so vulnerable to those Earthquakes, to those Facades, particularly when you know that it can't support either the Cresselia, thanks to the Safety Goggles, or the Ursaluna if it's able to get that burn up early.
Yeah, I think that's the problem as well. Most of the time you think Amoongus is a great option in most Trick Room situations, but Federico really kind of locked out any ability for the Amoongus to perform well under that situation, you know. It can come in, but it can't support either Pokemon to slow the game down. And it's just going to take big attacks from the Ursaluna. I mean, you saw how powerful the Facade is. Once that burn is activated, it's just doing so much damage. And the Amoongus isn't really going to be able to take an Earthquake either. It hasn't got a Terror type that's really going to complement it there. So it feels very difficult for Abdullah to kind of get any footing in this match. It'll be interesting to see how he lines up going into this next one.
Well, game two is underway. We've got the Golden Go and Iron Hands out for Abdullah, and it's going to be the Urshifu and Iron Hands for Federico. A lot of offensive pressure straight out of the blocks.
Yeah, and the Goldingo not in the greatest position again. The single strike Urshifu here from Federico's side, a really nice call. It is going to be a little bit threatened by the Iron Hands on the opposite side of the field, of Abdullah's side of the field. But the Goldingo probably not going to be doing that much damage here, so maybe a good time to switch it out, save it for later, maybe get something else in, like the Amoongus potentially here could come in, soak up maybe a Wicked Blow. But if you can get a Fake Out into that Urshifu slot, it would be helpful.
Yeah, that's the thing. The fake out, so tempting to break the focus sash on Federico's side. But here's the Chiempao going to be lowering the defenses. No fake out, it's just going to be a wicked burrow straight into that Chiempao. Focus sash is now broken on that side, once again leaving it so incredibly vulnerable to the follow up of the wild charge. That's a KO. Chiempao is down and out early doors in game two.
Once again, Abdullah losing that Chiempao without really much return, and even worse this time because he hasn't got that damage onto the Iron Hands. We are going to see a drain punch from the Iron Hands on his side of the field, taking the Urshifu down to 19 HP, but it's still around the next turn, making it very difficult as the Amoongus now hits the field. And again, we're left in that same situation with those three Pokemon that we had from that game one, and it feels like an uphill struggle already for Abdullah in this top eight match.
Maybe Abdullah was thinking the Urshifu was going to switch out. The fake out was so tempting to break the focus sash, and possibly you could then catch the Ursaluna coming in with that drain punch, and that would leave it in a more vulnerable position. But bold plays from Federico staying in at this point, now forcing Abdullah to make these adjustments, switching out and bringing that Golden Go back in.
Yeah, and I think the Amoongus probably offers some sort of offensive pressure here with a Pollen Puff onto that Urshifu, at least to be able to knock it out and take it down and even the score up a little bit going into this next turn. But we are seeing the Terrestrialization here from the Urshifu. It is going for that Dark Terror type here. So it is going to be doing even bigger damage this next turn, particularly if it goes for a Wicked Blow into that Amoongus. It'll be interesting to see how much damage it actually does do.
It means business. It's not enough to get a KO, but a significant chunk of damage goes into that Amoongus. The follow-up with Heavy Slam fails to be able to get the knockout, leaving Amoongus free to go for the Pollen Puff and get the KO. But I still think that damage onto the Amoongus is huge. The one issue, however, is it survives the turn. You could possibly switch it out, use that regenerate ability to regain a little bit of HP, but at what cost?
Yeah, at what cost? I think that's the big thing. The Amoongus not in any shape to take in a single attack now. The Cresselia coming onto the field, and you don't really have a way. The Goldinger's not set up at this point. If it had a nasty plot at this stage in the game, you think, okay, you might have a chance to stop this Cresselia getting the Trick Room up. But we're back in that same situation where Cresselia's on the field. It's not threatened by a knockout here. It can't be put to sleep. Goldinger can go for a nasty plot, but if the Iron Hands leaves the field now and that Ursaluna comes onto the field, you're in that same situation again with the Trick Room set up, the Ursaluna on the field with that Flame Orb. The only difference this time around is that the Urshifu has used the Terrestrialization on Federico's side of the field. So that is something the Ursaluna cannot go for this time around. It will be subjected to all of the type weaknesses it has in its base form.
That's very true, leaving itself a little bit more vulnerable. Love to see the nasty plot on the Golden Go there. There's really not a lot that can be done to stop Trick Room from going up here. I think Abdullah realizing, hey, that's going to happen anyway. I might as well put myself in the best position to try and get some knockouts, giving your Golden Go plus two special attack.
Yeah, and now it has the option to really take advantage of this Shadow Ball, especially into the Iron Hands here. You can go for maybe the fake out into the Cresselia, or you can double into that Cresselia. You know it hasn't got Protect, so you can really stop it attacking this turn. Go for the Shadow Ball. Maybe pick up the knockout or at least get close to it. You could fire off and make it rain as well if you wanted to, but you're probably wasting that special attack drop if it does go for that. Although, the Ursaluna now going to hit the field. Make it rain might not be the worst shout at all.
Well, that's the thing. You don't want to Shadow Ball into that slot that was the Cresselia, because Ursaluna's not going to mind that at all. Golden Go taking a huge chunk of damage, to be fair, from the Iron Hands. Going to be able to activate its berry. Not an item we usually see on the Golden Go, but nice to see it having a Citrus Berry in its back pocket as the Drain Punch comes through into the opposing Iron Hands. Honestly, these Iron Hands are pretty happy on the field at the minute, just re-changing up a little bit of their HP, getting a bit of recoil, and it is the Shadow Ball. Fantastic switch there from Federico.
Yeah, getting that Flame Orb activation on the switch in as well. The immunity it's got through its normal type into those ghost type attacks gets it onto the field for free, and now it's in a position where the Iron Hands on Federico's side can just switch out to the Cresselia and an Earthquake can come out. And you know, the Goldinger's almost forced at this stage to go for that Flying Terror type. Now, does Federico read into that and go for the Facade into that Goldinger? If you do it and it doesn't terrestrialize, you're going to waste a turn, and you may allow it then to get that Make It Rain off, which could be quite detrimental to your game plan. Or do you just play it safe, get the Cresselia in and just go for that Earthquake and hope that you don't see the Terrestrialization?
I mean, alternatively, you could maybe go for Protect on Golden Go, maybe go for your Terrestrialization on the Iron Hands into Grass Terror, maybe try and survive the Earthquake and then go for a Drain Punch into that Ursaluna.
Whether really
or
like
not, whether or not it's going to be able to get the KO though, that is the question. I think you've only really got one shot in order to remove this Ursaluna from the field. Cresselia switches in, really wouldn't be surprised to see the Earthquake coming out, but here's that Terrestrialization. Who's it going to be, Lee?
It's going to be the Iron Hands, you call it there, and the Grass Terror typing. Going to be able to take that Earthquake so much better now with that typing, and it is going to be able to pressure that Ursaluna with that Drain Punch. We are going to see the Earthquake come out, and it will be hitting the Goldingo. It doesn't affect the Cresselia because of the Levitate, but the Iron Hand's taking that so comfortably, and it's primed to get a Drain Punch off into that Ursaluna now. Is it enough, though?
You know, would love to have seen a Protect on that Goldingo there. The Drain Punch actually going into the Cresselia slot there. Not going to be targeting down the Ursaluna. That turn did not go the way Abdullah wanted, but it went perfectly for Federico.
Yeah, and now obviously the facade is going to be the issue for the Iron Hands. And, you know, the Amoonga is still available for Abdullah, so he can bring it in. He can redirect this turn and potentially give the Iron Hands one more turn, but has it got enough to be able to take down the Ursaluna? And then you've got to concentrate on the Cresselia, and I don't know if it's got enough in the tank at this stage to be able to kind of deal with three Pokemon by itself if the Amoongus goes for that Rage Powder.
Exactly, and Ursaluna just going for Protect here, wanting to see what Abdullah is going to be up to as you go through these last turns of Game 2. It's going to be the Leaf Storm. Even with a critical hit, there's not a lot that the Amoongus can do. Its special attack is dropping as well with each of those, and the Drain Punch once again very underwhelming into that Cresselia. Nice to get the double up though, thinking, hey, I think that Ursaluna is going to go for a Protect, and you might as well try and get some HP where you can. And Cresselia does also go for that Trick Room.
Yeah, and I think predicting there maybe the Ally Switch coming out from Federico's side while we see the double up
That's good, into that slot
because it makes sense that you could go for it there in that precarious position, going for the Leaf Storm double up with that Drain Punch. It would have been enough to get the Ursaluna. The Leaf Storm now coming out from the Amoongus, lowering that special attack by two stages, not going to be enough. And now the Lunar Blessing coming out. The Trick Room reversed here, going to be able to get that off and just keep itself and the Ursaluna as healthy as possible.
Cresselia's got this game exactly where it wants it to at this point. Being able to go for that Lunar Blessing, taking these Drain Punches again. Abdullah, I think, really trying to catch one of these potential ally switches, but Cresselia just staying strong and steady, regaining that HP with Lunar Blessing as Ursaluna is free to keep going for these Earthquakes. There's only so many of these that both these Grass types on the opposing side can take. They manage it on this occasion, but those Facades will be coming through as well. Once again, the double up into Cresselia, it's so bulky and these moves are so underwhelming at this point. Ursaluna is sitting there completely unchecked.
Yeah, and the one drawback about that Lunar Blessing is it does cure the burn, so it does mean that Guts boost isn't activated anymore, but it doesn't really matter at this point because of the health so high, and it's just out of reach for both these Pokemon to be able to pick up the knockout here as we see the Moonblast enough to pick up the Amoongus and Forfeit coming out. Federico will be moving on to the top four of the tournament at the World Championships here in Yokohama.
We have our first top four competitor, Federico, and look at the camaraderie between these two players. Give it up for them if you're here in the venue and back at home. Make sure you're supporting them too. What an excellent match for our top eight.